In the first days of February, when the ice still covers the mountains, the golden eagles have already lined their nests with fresh plant cover. They prepare for the nesting process. They cover two or three different platforms on inaccessible rocks, generally oriented in shadows. I have gone down to a golden eagle nest so that through my eyes you can see how beautiful the green, mimetic, refreshing cover that the queen of birds has placed is. It is currently hovering over me with its imposing silhouette. We intend to make a film about the golden eagle. We want to collect all of their biology so that by getting to know this formidable monarch of the air better, they will realize that there are very few left and that we have the obligation to protect them. The powerful flight of the golden eagle can carry the queen of birds from the low gullies, where it sometimes builds its nest, to the mountains of perpetual snow. The eagle, sheltered today in the mountains, has also dominated the lowlands and valleys. Specifically, it nests in the ground in the Arctic tundra. In the coniferous zone of the taiga, it builds nests in trees. In Europe, subject to human pressure, it has taken refuge in the mountains. Contemplating the flight of the eagle, it is understandable that man has admired this bird throughout all of prehistory and history. It has been confirmed in the excavations that fossil remains of eagle bones were common in some primitive tribes which undoubtedly adorned themselves with the feathers of the mythical bird as the redskins of the Great Prairie did later. The Roman legions decorated their emblems with an eagle with spread wings. All the powerful kingdoms and empires on earth have put the golden eagle on their shields. More modernly, when man, in the most formidable adventure of modern times, reached the moon for the first time, the lunar landing module in honor of the Queen of Birds was called the Eagle. Thanks to its tireless flight and fantastic technique for gliding and diving, the eagle appears to be unfatigued, effortless. It can dominate its immense fiefdom, often made up of the entire massif of a mountain range. The eagle that we have momentarily taken out of its nest to present to the followers of our series has been able to climb the high mountain with complete peace of mind. Then, dominating the most beautiful territories, the coniferous forests, the gorges, it will descend without apparent effort. Observing and dominating the landscape as man had not been able to do until it invented modern aviation machines. The eagle, as always and throughout time, dominates the immense territory of its hunts. It can be argued that the lion is the king of animals. It can be argued that this or that species dominates others. It is perfectly clear that in holarctic latitudes, where the golden eagle lives, it is the most powerful of all existing birds. A few minutes after being expelled from the nest, the eagle will return to the platform it is preparing to receive the laying of the queen of birds in mid-March or the first days of April. Scaring the red-billed chobos that at that time are also found on the eve of the mating. The eagle from the cliff where it has placed its nest powerfully dominates the entire fiefdom through its vision, where it can hunt from a chamois to a mouse. Eagles usually locate their nests in areas that allow them to dominate very large regions. Through their powerful eyesight, they could theoretically dominate the haughty chamois who is near the perpetual snow. The eagle will carefully study the small flock to choose a suitable prey. It will also dominate the hare and rabbit that are found either in the snow or in the lower areas of the valley. It will easily discover shy partridges, and even the solitary capercaillie will be discovered at the announcement stop by the queen of birds. The powerful view of the shaven reaches all points of the mountain, sees the mountain goats. And on the middle floors, the mouflon fearfully begins the race, despite the powerful raptor's great corpulence. At the dawn of spring, the red-billed choughs are already carrying tufts of wool to their nests. Red-billed birds and golden eagles are frequent neighbors. Many times, the former are prey to the latter. Eagles bring huge branches to the nest. It is hard to believe that a flying bird can carry pieces of wood of such weight and size to its platforms. Many of the branches they bring still have leaves, new or old, from the previous year. They pluck them in one pass over the treetops, and then they place them meticulously on the large platform of the nest. Meanwhile, the redbills fill the air with their high-pitched tone. And they are also dedicated to the mating rituals and the construction of the sheltered nest, which is always tucked in a small crevice. From January to April, the golden eagle makes its breeding and territorial stops. These consist of a down and up flight, playing with the air, thanks to its mastery of the aerial medium. It weaves and weaves these aerial filigrees while its voice fills the fresh atmosphere of the mountain. The female contemplates the male from its nest, who in some way is telling everyone that they rule that mountain range. Many times, the golden eagle's nuptial stops take place at more than 2,000 meters above sea level. The male eagle is nothing more than a point in the sky, while the female is down in the gully, repairing all the nests without knowing which one to decide on to lay the eggs. The eagles bother the redbills little on those days while they are mating. But not only is the male dedicated to marking the territory, it also sometimes collaborates with the female in rebuilding the nest. It remains already laid. First, it is about to lay a white egg with spots or cracks, and 3 or 4 days later, the second one. It is believed that these days between the first and second eggs are those that will determine the death of almost all the chicks that are born from the second egg laid. Because if the eagles lay 3 eggs at most, 2 normally and 1 usually, the truth is that a single chick is usually the most frequent rate of reproduction in these birds, 2 in 30 or 40% of cases, and 3 in exceptional conditions. While the female golden eagle incubates the eggs, a task that lasts 43 to 45 days, while moving them so that the heat reaches all their areas regularly, the male permanently either dedicates to hunting or marks its territory high in the sky. The departure of the eagle, surely determined by the motor of our camera, allows us to contemplate the laying of 2 eggs. And it also allows us to see the perfectly camouflaged mass of branches in which the eggs have been deposited. At the dawn of spring, the trees in the valleys and mountain gullies are already covered with flowers. There is a whole symphony of trills of the greenfinches, of the jirgueros, of the thrushes, of all the birds of our mountain valleys, while the long 45 days go by as the golden eagle remains lying on the eggs.
It has been found that the eagle leaves the incubation for very few minutes. Then it is replaced by a male.
But the truth is that before the little birds begin building their nests, a miracle will have already happened on the proud platform of the golden eagle. The little eaglet has just been born, just a few minutes ago, and we have been lucky enough to show you this helpless, tiny creature just hatched from the egg. It seems unbelievable that it transforms into such a powerful bird, a mythical bird. The little eaglets come into the world already covered in dense white down, which will contribute, in addition to the heat provided by the mother, to free them from the low temperatures of the high mountains. Seeing the eagle with its newborn chick, one realizes the tenderness of the maternal instinct, of the care with which the queen of birds, who has so often been considered as the most genuine representation of pride, strength, and misunderstood cruelty, it is also capable of caring for her little one. But the male golden eagle, during those days, is perching on the other platforms of the old nests, as if it wanted to prepare them for the following year. For 3 or 4 weeks, the golden eagle practically remains on the chick. It cleans the nest of any element that could hurt or harm it. It pecks at it gently. It lets it sunbathe or cover it completely with its soft feathers when the cold descends. Alone, at the mercy of this caretaking, the eagle can raise such a small and helpless chick that it will remain in the nest for about 3 months. Mid-April, when the golden eagle chicks are born, the foxes, fresh from the foxholes, are already patrolling many of our gullies and mountains. They are easy prey for golden eagles. It has been proven that these birds of prey contribute to maintaining the status of the fox population. And the partridges, which come into heat in the month of February, are also in full ardor of love. It is known that the song, "The Gallant Posture of Male Partridges," attracts the attack of golden eagles. That at that time almost exclusively males hunt. They contribute to maintaining the status of the population of these appreciated gallinaceous. Already in its first hours of life, the eaglet is fed by the mother. To do this, from a piece provided by the male, the eagle chooses the most delicate morsels. If any of them are too big for the little one, the mother herself swallows them. During the first weeks of the eaglet's lives, feeding is relatively frequent. As they grow, they are fed less often. In the first days of life of the little ones, golden eagles hunt mainly birds. And as we have seen, it is sometimes the male partridges that attract the eagle's zaka. Ninety percent of the partridge remains that we found in the eagle nests during filming had large spurs on their legs. Harriers that consume delicate prey during the first days of life grow rapidly. Already at 3 weeks, covered in white down, they are able to identify their peers from a long distance. They call them with pitiful cries, and shortly the eagle abandons its little one. When it does so, it is to collaborate with the male in the hunt. Because as the eaglets grow, their appetite increases. During this time, eagles attack large prey. It is precisely in high spring when the golden eagles attack the chamois. It has been seen that isolated specimens generally injured or prey to infectious diseases, particularly attack bird queens. Thank you. But evidently, eagles hunt because their young and themselves have to feed on meat. With less drama, the man does exactly the same thing. On the other hand, golden eagles, which undeniably capture many chamois, especially young ones, are the best defenders of this species. Specifically, in the Swiss Alps, at the beginning of the century, as a result of the extermination of a large number of pairs of golden eagles, a great scabies epidemic broke out that almost wiped out the alpine chamois. Once again, eagles had to be reintroduced to the old cantons. Today, these birds, as a consequence of their scarcity on the one hand and also as a consequence of their beneficial action on animals of hunting interest, are always protected by law throughout our national territory. When not hunting, the male continues to stand guard, often at great heights, over the breeding territory. There are few animals that are as protected as harriers, almost all day digesting with a full crop, playing already at 3 weeks or so with the strands of feathers or hair that remain on the construction sticks. But the eaglet will have to see many things before it can fly through the sky like its parents. It will have to be nurtured, protected, defended. The life of the eagle, which is a pure adventure, already during the first days of its childhood, it is pointing out all the great beauty of a story that has mythical overtones. But this story, dear friends, will be the topic for the next episode that we dedicate to the Golden Eagle.